Hi there, Caity from All About Balloons, and today's Be Brilliant tip is for one of my favorite decor elements, Megaloons. This tip is a great temporary use for when you're trying to get your Megaloons set, whether you're going to do them in helium, at the same height, on an arch, or if you're putting them in an air-filled installation like a marquee. Megaloons are some of my favorite balloons to use. They make a huge impact. And they're great whether you fill them with air or helium. So my favorite trick for getting them consistently the same height is to tape them ahead of time. So I've got a few out here on my shop floor, and what I'm going to do is actually tape them before I inflate them. So this will allow me to sort of line up the top and the bottom, and because I'm only going to use packing tape, if it's messed up when I'm done, I can just undo it and redo it again. So I have lined up, for the most part, my H and my O here, and there it's not right to the middle, right? The H and the O don't line up in the middle. So you sort of have to set them out and take a look and make sure that they're lining up the way that you want them to. So that's what I've done here. You also need to do it upside down. So because this is an H and an O, it doesn't really matter. But you need to do it upside down or backward, depending on how your brain works, so that the tape will be on the backside when you're done inflating it. So all I'm gonna do is use my weighted tape dispenser, which I got from Amazon for, I don't know, probably 20 bucks or so. And what's really nice about this is because it's weighted, it doesn't require two hands. It does just now because I flew the tape out of it, but normally it does not require two hands. So this is just cheap, clear packing tape. There's nothing special about it. Again, I get everything pretty much from Amazon. You can get it from any office supply place. Any big box store is gonna have, you know, regular clear packing tape. And then I'm just gonna literally place a piece onto my letters that I have set next to each other. So I'm gonna go ahead and place two pieces just so that I know it's gonna stick together when I inflate it. Then what I'm gonna do is use my extension gun from my helium tank. Let me go ahead and just tape the letter that you can't really see off screen, but you will when I'm done. It's a D, so I'm just gonna tape those two together with my cheap packing tape. Now I'm gonna take my helium gun and I'm going to go ahead and inflate these. And then you'll see once they're inflated that they're stuck together and already pretty much the same height. Oops. So helium guns are a little tricky. You really need to know how well foil balloons are gonna react to them. You know, you need to know when to stop inflating, when to sort of slow it down, and you never want to go too fast because you don't want to damage the valve inside the foil balloon. So I'm kind of holding down the H because, you know, it is full of helium. Now it wants to float. Now I'm going to do my O. I'm gonna do my D. And I'm just letting them go because the tape is holding them together. So, you know, they can sort of fly up and it doesn't really matter. Let me get my... See, I slowed down because the D is the kind that has the seam in the middle. So I slowed my helium down so that I don't blow out that little bit there. Although these are pretty tough and I have a super low failure rate with them. I use Megaloons exclusively. These are all put together. They're about the same height. And, you know, I don't need to go and do each single one of them individually. I'm able to put them together like this. Not in the state of California, but I can do it other places. So you could singly weight these. Even when they're taped together, you can still apply each one to a single weight if you need to. So I hope you enjoyed this bBrilliant tip, and stay tuned for more.